Onabugeisha were female warriors belonging to the Japanese nobility, members of the Bushi or Samurai class. These women engaged in battle, commonly alongside samurai men, and trained to use weapons to protect their household, family, and honor in times of war. The most significant examples of Onabugeisha were Tomo Gozen, Nakano Takeko, and Empress Yingo. They were trained in the same way men were, in self-defense and offensive maneuvers. They were even trained to use a weapon specifically designed for women to allow them better balance given their smaller stature, called a naginata. For years, they fought alongside the male samurai, being held to the same standards and expected to perform the same duties. One of the first female samurai warriors was Empress Yingu. She used her skills to inspire economic and social change. She was recognized as the Onabugeisha who led an invasion of Korea in 200 AD after her husband, Emperor Chuai, the 14th Emperor of Japan, was slain in battle. After Empress Yingu paved the way, another Onabugeisha rose through the ranks. Tomo Gozen, servant of Minamoto of the Minamoto clan, assisted Yoshinaka in defending himself against the forces of his cousin. She was a strong archer, and as a swordswoman, she was a warrior worth 1,000, ready to confront a demon or a god. She handled unbroken horses with superb skill. She rode unscathed down perilous descents. Whenever a battle was imminent, Yoshinaka sent her out as his first captain, equipped with strong armor, an oversized sword, and a mighty bow, and she performed more deeds of valor than any of his other warriors. Her troops listened to her command, trusting her instincts. She engaged in politics, and word of her competency quickly spread through Japan. Before long, the master of the Minamoto clan named Tomo Gozen as Japan's first true general. Little is known of Tomo Gozen's fate after the battle. Some say she stayed and fought bravely to the death. Others claim she rode away on horseback carrying Morosai's head, though no reports of her surfaced after the battle. A few claim that she married a fellow samurai and became a nun after his death. For centuries after Tomo Gozen's reign, the Onabugeisha flourished. Female warriors made up a large part of the samurai, protecting villages and opening more schools around the Japanese Empire to train young women in the art of war and the use of the naginata. Though there were many different clans spread throughout Japan, all of them included samurai warriors, and all were open to the Onabugeisha. Eventually, during a period of unrest between the ruling Tokugawa clan and the imperial court in 1868, a group of special female warriors, known as the Joshitai, was created, ruled over by a 21-year-old Onabugeisha named Nakano Takeko. Takeko had been highly trained to use a naginata, the shorter, lighter version of the traditional weapon. In addition, she had been trained in martial arts and had been highly educated throughout her life, as her father was a high-ranking official in the imperial court. Under her command, the Yoshitai moved to follow the male samurai into the Battle of Aizu. They fought bravely alongside the male warriors, killing a number of opposing male warriors in close combat. Unfortunately, even the highest skilled Onabugeisha couldn't survive a shot to the heart, and Takeko was felled during the battle. However, with her last breath, she asked her sister to behead her so that her body wouldn't be taken as an enemy trophy. Her sister took on her request, burying her head in the roots of the pine tree in the temple Aizo Bangemachi. A monument was later built there in her honor. Takeko is widely considered to be the last great female samurai warrior, and the Battle of Aizu is considered the last stand of the Onabugeisha. Shortly after, the shogunate, the feudal Japanese military government, fell, leaving the imperial court to take over leadership. Though the Onabugeisha ended their reign, for the most part after Takeko, women warriors still remained. Through the 1800s, women continued to defy traditional gender roles and participated in battles. After centuries of conforming to stereotypes created by men, often overlooked by scholars and rarely remembered by the public, these women made their marks by making trouble. They rebelled, changed laws, and shattered gender barriers. Join us as we shine the light and celebrate the contribution these badass women made in history. Thank you for watching, and join me next time.